This is the Kasaragod District Collectorate in Kerala. While the state of Kerala has attracted global attention, this particular district has been held up by the center as an example of a containment policy and a response to the pandemic that can and should be followed. So what did this district in the northern area of Kerala do differently? Let's meet the collector here. Thank you, sir. Let's just walk a little bit through your collectorate. And while we're walking, of course, we've heard a lot about your area. The center itself held it up as a example of what can be done, what should be done. You've seen two waves of infection. Yeah. First, when you had a case come in from Wuhan, then you had people returning from the Gulf. Yeah. And now you could be looking at a third wave as more people return. Yeah. If you had to say in one line what Kasaragod has done differently, what would it be?
Ma'am, it's perfectly, you know, we have done very good homework. And another thing I would say, it is centralized planning and perfect decentralized execution. That is the key for success in Kasaragod. In the first case, we had one case from Wuhan.
Yeah.
Then after that, we had 178 in the second wave.
Yeah.
And now we have 53 cases.
Okay.
Not even a single death. That is the most important aspect in the case of Kasaragod. Huh. You may be knowing, you know, we are not that perfect in the case of health facilities over here.
Yeah.
We don't have any medical colleges over here.
Mm.
And even the government facilities are minimum here compared with other districts.
Mm.
But no, we could manage perfectly. No, I would give the credit to the people here. Well, whatever the district administration said, they have been very good. No, they were following like anything.
Now, there was very, very aggressive contact tracing. In fact, I was reading that the student who came back from Wuhan, who was evacuated,
yeah,
150 of his primary and secondary contracts were actually traced out.
Yeah, ma'am. Actually, the contact tracing. We have a perfect team of junior health inspectors, doctors, and all.
Hmm.
They have been on the job since the first case, and you know, we have been doing it professionally, and now we are quite experienced. And contact tracing is one of the key. Then the way we trace them and mark them, then we do the surveillance. We have created from March 13th itself, we created a local level body. It's called the ward level Janajagrata Samiti.
Hmm.
It consists of the ward member, then a policeman, then a junior health inspector, then an ASHA worker. These people, these four people, along with the other members in the group, they do a perfect surveillance over each and every patient and also the contacts. So we are not allowing anyone to go out of the premises.
Now, you were using drones, you were using GPS for surveillance. Yeah. Can you tell us a little bit about how drones and GPS was used?
Ma'am, though more than 99% of the people cooperate with the district administration for the surveillance activity, very few, you know, they were not following our conditions.
Mm.
So just to track them, you know, they were hiding and they were forming groups, outskirts. So just to track them, we use the drone technology, and we were using that. Then the surveillance, you know, the police has been doing a fantastic work here. We were the first to introduce ERPC 144. To be precise, just after that Janata Hartal on 22nd, from 9 p.m. on that day, we started the...
So 144 across the district.
Yeah, yeah.
And at one point, more than 17,000 people were quarantined?
Yeah, more than 17,000 people were quarantined. And the room quarantine, even that particular thing, instead of, you know, we have been telling like, you know, home quarantine, we started using the room quarantine concept. So the person, when my fourth patient transmitted the disease to my fifth, sixth and seventh patient, we started telling room quarantine instead of home quarantine. That was from March 20th, we started telling it should be room quarantine. Because if the person mix up with his family member, definitely, you know, we cannot do anything.
Now explain to me, do you go and see whether the place is clean enough to work as a room quarantine? Because one of the things we're following now is as trains come in, first administrators have to see if the quarantine facility at home is okay or whether institutional quarantine is needed. Can you talk a little bit about
ma'am,
this?
It's like this. When we have a portal called COVID-19 Jagrata portal. Oh. So see, like, you want to come in Kerala, you must have experience now. You will have to register. Before entering Kerala, you have to register in a portal called COVID-19 Jagrata.
Mm.
In that portal, if you are given your address like Chengala Panchayat, the Chengala Panchayat member will go to your house and see whether you have a single room with a toilet facility. If yes, definitely they will say, no, he can be put in his room quarantine.
So every single person who is coming back, I just want our viewers to understand this. Yeah. So if you are registering to return home to Kerala, a panchayat member or a local administrator, sir, will first go to your house, not just to your house, will check the room in which you have to be quarantined and will check your toilet facility.
We will be checking that. And only after getting a concurrence from that local body member, the district collector issues the pass. Then only they can come in.
Very interesting. Yeah. And now, one of the problems that your area has faced is one that it did not have a speciality hospital. Many people from here would have to actually go into Karnataka to get treatment, whether they were non-COVID patients also had to really struggle. Yeah. Yeah. Then Karnataka sealed its borders. Yeah. You're at the northernmost tip. Yeah. How did you handle this?
Ma'am, actually, we have a helping hand from Kannur district, my neighboring district in Kerala. And we have been, in the most critical patients, we used to transmit them transfer them to Kannur district, and actually it is an eye opener for us. Now we started a medical college. We could start that OP in medical college within 4 days after CMS announced it. Then now
we started a medical college functional in 4 days.
Just 4 days, we started the OP there. Then now within 2 months we'll be setting up another hospital. It is almost maybe some 20-30% work is over. You can cover that. It is
from scratch.
From nothing. Nothing was there.
In 2 months, there's a hospital coming up from scratch.
You know, we are doing it better than China here. You can go and cover if you want.
We'll go and have a look. Yeah. But what are the challenges you're facing? And like I asked you in the beginning, the worry about a third wave. Yeah. You've dealt with two. Yeah. You have now people coming, by road, by train. By the end of the year, Kerala is expecting about 3 lakh people to come back overall. And in your district, because it's remote, people are coming from everywhere. Lots of different parts of the state. How are you going to handle this?
Ma'am, we have sealed all the borders. We have 17 roads to Kasaragod, and we sealed almost 15 roads. Now we got only 2 roads coming to Kasaragod. There we have a perfect checking mechanism. And we appeal to everyone who wish to come to Kasaragod, please register in our COVID-19 Jagrada. If COVID-19 Jagrada, you register in that, we can perfectly trace you. Even we can help you a lot. If you register in COVID-19 Jagrada and if you are staying in Kerala, definitely you will be getting minimum 5 calls in a day.
Like what about poor people? At least in the north, we've seen this. A lot of poor workers don't have access to technology. Yeah. They don't. Their mobile phones are not working. What are they supposed to do?
Ma'am, what we have done is, in both our counters, there at Kalikadava in the south and in Thalapadi in the north, we have set up a help desk for them. And there, people, we have posted teachers there from the IT school teachers. They'll be helping the people. You just need to have a phone number or your lady's phone number. You just need to give the phone number. Then we will enter the data, and even we take a printout of the your pass. Then we hand it over. Like then we are helping the people.
One last question I ask every bureaucrat and every frontline warrior this. What keeps you up at night? What keeps you sleepless? What's your biggest worry? And are you worried for yourself?
we cannot think like that, no? Because we are for the people.
That's true. But what keeps you sleepless at night? What's your biggest worry right now?
I don't have any worries, ma'am. Because only one thing is that, ma'am, don't come to Kasaragod without registering COVID-19 in Jagrada portal. If you register, you are safe. And you will be in safe in the government's hand. And if you are not registering and coming, then that will be the most... with the biggest worry for us.
Well, we wish you all the best. You have another inflection point right now as people come back.
Hope not so.
We have to hope not so. So while Kerala remains a global example, here Kasaragod in Kerala at its northernmost tip, talking to the collector, is an example that's been held up by the central government of what a district can do. And it's very interesting, the involvement of grassroots politicians and grassroots administrators in keeping Kerala as not free, I would say, but at least as unscathed by the pandemic as is possible.